In a world where our personal failings often define us, how can we find true strength and redemption? Society today may idolize a record of flawless success, but the biblical narrative of Samson paints a starkly different picture. It's a story that breaks down the conventional view of strength, revealing a hero whose power is as riddled with flaws as it is with might. Join us on a journey through ancient scripture to uncover a message of spiritual rebirth that speaks powerfully into our lives right now. Did you know that the mighty Samson, often remembered for his superhuman physical strength, embarked on a personal journey as marked by weakness as it was by power? By delving into the twists and turns of his saga, we discover a profound truth about the human condition, that within our greatest vulnerabilities lies the potential for transformative strength. In a world that often equates physical prowess and dominance with ultimate strength, it's easy to lose sight of the subtler, more enduring power within us. It's a concept vividly illustrated in the life of Samson, the legendary figure whose feats of strength are still spoken of today. But what is often overlooked is how his story is as much about the failings tied to his might as it is about the strength itself. This dual narrative provides us with a mirror reflecting our own society's obsession with power and the inherent risks that come with it. Consider for a moment a modern parallel, a young athlete heralded for their natural talent and poised for a career laden with victories and fame. Their physical gifts elevate them above peers, creating an image of invincibility. Yet, just like Samson, they face temptations and pressures that threaten to undermine their integrity and purpose. The athlete's journey reminds us that strength, when not tempered with wisdom and humility, can lead to pride and eventual downfall. It's a story that echoes through the ages, from Samson's era to our high-stakes, performance-driven culture. Samson's encounters with Delilah reveal how our greatest weaknesses often stem from our greatest strengths. Just as this hero was undone by his confidence in his unassailable might, we too can be blindsided by the things we believe make us strong. Our talents can become our traps, leading us into a false sense of security and away from the true source of our power. Samson's story serves as a cautionary tale, warning us to remain vigilant and grounded, lest our personal Delilahs find and exploit the chinks in our armor. Through these narratives, we are prompted to reflect on the nature of true strength. Is it measured by the weight one can lift, or by the resilience of the spirit? Can we find greater power in vulnerability and trust than in stubborn self-reliance? These are the questions that Samson's tale urges us to ask ourselves. As we unravel the strands of his complex legacy, we uncover timeless truths about the essence of real strength and the path to discovering it within ourselves. As we delve deeper into the saga of Samson, our introspection brings us to the mysterious Nazirite vows that he took. Scholars have long debated the symbolic significance of these vows, particularly concerning Samson's long hair, which was not just a feature of his appearance, but an external sign of his sacred promise to God. Imagine for a moment this powerful figure, his hair representing a tangible commitment to his Creator, much like the commitments we make in our own lives, promises to family, to friends, and to values that define who we are. When Samson's locks are deceitfully shorn by Delilah, it's not merely a haircut, it's a severing of his spiritual lifeline, manifesting his broken vows. This act serves as a poignant metaphor for the consequences we face when we compromise our integrity. In today's world, personal and public commitments are easily made, but often just as easily broken. Like strands of hair, they can seem insignificant individually, but together create a strength that holds up against life's adversities. As we reflect on this part of the story, let's consider how our own commitments shape our identity and direction. Have we ever experienced the disorientation that comes with failed promises? What is the impact on our lives, and how do we rebuild trust, both in ourselves and with others, when covenants are broken? Samson's experience with Delilah forces us to confront the uncomfortable truth that sometimes our greatest betrayals come not from external enemies, but from within. From the very people we have allowed close enough to wield the metaphorical shears. We all have our own version of Nazirite vows, binding us to a set of principles or a higher purpose. How we uphold these pledges amidst life's temptations and trials speaks volumes about our character and spiritual fortitude. Samson's story, marked by a profound loss of strength following the breaking of his vow, reminds us of the importance of staying true to our convictions, no matter the seductive powers that may seek to lead us astray. In the wake of his betrayal, Samson finds himself at his weakest, physically blind and spiritually desolate, a mere shell of the formidable man he once was. His strength, once unrivaled, had become his greatest vulnerability, leading to a downfall that seemed final. And yet, it is in this very weakness that a profound transformation begins to take root within him. As he grinds grain in the prisons of the Philistines, Samson is confronted with the stark reality of his failures. The introspection is bitter but necessary. It prompts us to ask ourselves, what are your personal Delilahs that can lead you astray, and how do you guard against them? Each one of us faces temptations that challenge our resolve and reveal our vulnerabilities. How can we, like Samson, recognize our weaknesses and seek not just to resist temptation, but to fortify our spirits in the face of it? Reflect upon the seductions of contemporary life, be they the pursuit of status, wealth, or pleasures, and how these may sometimes blind us to our true purpose. Like Samson, we may be shackled by our own missteps, but it doesn't have to be the end of our story. In the moments of our greatest trials, there lies an opportunity for redemption and a return to the path that leads to spiritual fulfillment. Samson's plight invites each of us to consider the power of humility and penitence, compelling us to acknowledge our fallibility and to seek reinvention through faith. By sharing our own experiences and understanding how others have navigated their moral compass amid tempestuous seas, we forge a collective wisdom that can light the path forward, not just for ourselves, but for the community we are a part of. Let this be a moment of reflection on the Delilahs in our lives and how we can emerge stronger, not in spite of our weaknesses, but because we have faced them with courage and conviction. In the moments before his final act, Samson finds himself bereft of all that once defined him, his strength, his sight, and seemingly his mission. Yet in this state of ultimate vulnerability, he discovers a deeper connection to his faith and an inner strength he had not tapped into before. Through visual depictions of Samson's prayer and the Philistines' temple, we are reminded that true strength often arises from the ruins of our own prideful strongholds. Consider the metaphor of the collapsing temple. As it crumbled under the weight of Samson's renewed conviction, so too can our false perceptions of control and self-reliance fall away when we embrace genuine trust in God's plan. In our modern lives, we construct many temples, be they our careers, relationships, or personal aspirations. And like Samson, we are sometimes called to let these crumble, to trust in a greater power beyond our understanding. How often do we stand amidst the rubble of our plans, feeling as though we've failed? Samson's redemption teaches us that even in the shock of lost dreams and in the wake of missteps, we are given the opportunity to renew our covenant with God. It is in surrender that we often find a paradoxical kind of victory, one that aligns our will with the divine and yields a transformation more profound than any success the world could offer. Finally, reflect on the structures you uphold in your life that might be keeping you from fully trusting in God's providence. Are you willing to let them fall if it means finding true strength in surrender? Let Samson's legacy challenge you to consider where your strength truly comes from and to recognize that sometimes redemption requires a return to the foundations of faith, built upon not by our hands, but by the will of God. As we draw this exploration to a close, we find ourselves contemplating the enduring message that Samson's life imparts. True strength is not measured by the might of our arms, but by the steadfastness of our spirit. The hero of old, with all his legendary power, was ultimately defined not by his physical prowess, but by his return to faith amidst his greatest weakness. Like Samson, we too can experience profound transformation, turning our most harrowing failures into milestones of redemption and spiritual awakening. In the echoing silence that follows our own moments of collapse, may we listen for that still small voice calling us back to the essence of our faith. With every ending, there is a new beginning. In every defeat, there is a lesson. And in every vulnerability, an opportunity for incredible rebirth awaits. The life of Samson reminds us that when our plans fall apart, it may be the divine dismantling what we've built to reveal a greater purpose we could never have constructed on our own. And now, we turn to you. How does Samson's journey resonate with your own? Where are you finding strength in the midst of trials? And how has faith redefined your understanding of true power? Share your reflections and stories in the comments below as we pursue this conversation together in community. If you're seeking further inspiration, consider subscribing to Divine Light for more content that illuminates the path where ancient wisdom meets modern living. Share this message with someone who might find solace in Samson's story, and keep exploring with us, perhaps starting with videos like The Parables of Jesus, Ancient Stories with Modern Meaning. Together, let's continue to unravel the mysteries of Scripture and their profound implications for our lives today. Thank you for joining us on this journey. Until next time, may your path be lit with understanding and your heart fortified with the strength that comes from above.